Amen. Praise God. Faithfulness and obedience from the life of Noah. Amen. Praise God. God bless you. My name is Minister Tracy Smith. Tracy Smith. You, some know me as Brother Cool Tracy, Minister Cool Tracy. You can find me on Facebook and on my ministry is called Souls of the Word. God bless you, LJA Rice. Welcome back to the broadcast. This is part two. We had to hour. We were doing pretty good, but then it started to freeze up. You know what I'm saying? And so we wisdom suggests that we stop the broadcast and rebroadcast so we get a clear picture for everybody. And if everybody can hear the sound, I don't have the music on right now because my spirit was getting stirred up. I'm over here sweating like it's July. You know what I'm saying? Like it's 4th of July. You know what I'm saying? The fire of God is moving. You know what I'm saying? Like that. I got me some tea over here. Hopefully it's a little warm. Thank God. I need y'all to pray for my strength in the Lord. I really do need your prayers. So I'm going to, you know what I'm saying, just do a little intro. Welcome those who are watching this on the rebroadcast replay. God bless you. And God bless you. Let me see. Hold on. Let me see if I can turn the light over here. I keep looking at that and thinking of something else. I think that's darkness. Well, no, that's weird. That's like that. What is that? That ain't got nothing to do with the light. Why is that? Because of the position, I guess the camera. Lord have mercy. I tell you, I'm going to have to just do what I got to do. I know people think I'd be looking down. Y'all bear with me. Bear with me. I'm trying to get the camera set up right and good the best way possible. So y'all bear with me here. This camera here. God bless you. Yeah, pull over here. Try to get a little closer. So y'all can get more of a better headshot of me. Let me turn up the light. Yeah. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Amen. I think that's a little bit better right there. So it don't look like I had like a dart. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, what is that? What is that? Amen. Welcome back, sister in Christ. God bless you. Welcome back. Amen. Thank you for inviting your followers. God bless you. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Let me have a little soup here. Soup just not lukewarm and cold. Lord have mercy. But we got to go on and be faithful and obedient, regardless of the soup is cold. Amen. Praise God. God bless you. I appreciate you very much, my dear sister. Very, very much. Amen. You know, give me feedback as much as possible. I looked and see, you know what I'm saying? There was a lot of people supposedly putting live viewers, but people just don't participate. They only say amen to the truth. I mean, maybe they popped in and left. I don't know. But you know what? That's what this word is about, yo. It's about learning faithfulness and obedience and being encouragement and receiving encouragement from the life of Noah. Amen. Praise God. I appreciate your feedback. You know, and people, you know what I'm saying? A lot of times, we get caught up, you know what I'm saying? And looking at what other people are doing, seeing their faithfulness and stuff, or maybe lack thereof. But we see everybody following them, supporting them. They're the best thing since sliced bread. But you know what? Maybe God sent those people in their life for them to be a blessing on their level so they can relate to them. You know, but we got to be faithful and obedient and stay encouraged and don't get disencouraged, you know what I'm saying, disheartened when, you know what I'm saying, we ain't got a crowd. You know what we going to learn? Noah didn't have a crowd. People probably was mocking him and everything, you know what I'm saying, but he stayed faithful and obedient to the Lord. He fulfilled the call of God, the assignment that God gave him, and that's what we're here for. God be for you, who can be against you? Amen. Amen. Praise God. You know, so, you know, we got to be faithful to what God, you know what I'm saying, is calling us to do. You know what I'm saying? You know, in Noah's day, we're going to see, you know what I'm saying? You know, it's I think, you know what I'm saying, 120 years, a grace period. But anyway, let me get back into the word. Because, you know, we were talking about these angels, sons of God, which these angels were, you know what I'm saying, they had a title, so to speak, of sons of God. But once they left their heavenly abode, they was rebelling and being disobedient to the Lord. God bless you. Welcome to the broadcast. We're in Genesis chapter 6. We're talking about learning faithfulness and obedience. faithfulness, obedience, and receiving encouragement from the life of Noah. A lot of people are self-righteous. You know, more than that, they are self-deceived. You know what I'm saying? Some of them deceive, and they're self-deceived. They hearers of the word, but not doers of the word. They don't want to hear the truth. They want somebody to tickle their ears, tell them what they want to hear. You know what I'm saying? But they're not faithful, obedient to the Lord. You know what I'm saying? Like that. And they don't think they're going to pay for that. We're going to see from the life of Noah and the people in his generation what had happened to them. You know what I'm saying? It came to pass when men began to multiply on the face of the earth that daughters were born to them, and that the sons of God saw the daughters of men that they were beautiful, and they took wives for themselves of all whom they chose. God says, lean not to your own understanding. Amen. You know what I'm saying? Those angels, you know what I'm saying? They left their heavenly estate, their heavenly abode. God created them to be in the heavenly realm with him, to praise and worship him, and to do his bidding as he gave them command. If he wanted to send them to the earth with an assignment, then he would send them. But they would just had liberty just be going down, you know what I'm saying, hooking up with, you know what I'm saying, with men's, with women. It said they took wives for themselves of all whom they chose. You know what I'm saying? So here they was leaving their heavenly abode. You know what I'm saying? We brought out that point about women. They're, you know what I'm saying, putting up all this makeup, getting their hair done, doing all this stuff, focusing on the outside appearances, you know what I'm saying, to attract the man. Whereas the angels of God, when they saw the daughters that were born to men, they saw that they were beautiful, and they left their heavenly estate to come down here and to take them to be their wives. So that's a strong point. I could stay there for a while. You know what I'm saying? So women of God, y'all got to know, don't get caught up, you know what I'm saying, on just your outer appearance. I'm not saying don't be, you know what I'm saying, keep yourself up and looking fine, but don't get caught up and spend all the money on makeup and jewelry and name brand clothes and trying to keep up the Joneses just to attract a man. Because if angels looking at you and they see you beautiful, you know what I'm saying? They not looking at all that. You know what I'm saying? And a true man of God, is the word of God said, man looks on the outward appearance, but God looks on the heart. So if we looking through the eyes of God, we looking for the spirit of God and the woman of God. And out of that, you know what I'm saying, it's going to manifest how she live. You know what I'm saying? Her work is going to speak for her, how she carry herself, how she conduct herself. A virtuous woman, yes, a submitted woman, you know what I'm saying? Submitted unto the men of God that God has ordained for her life to have authority, you know what I'm saying, to cover her, protect her, and provide for her. Love, share, and faith. God bless you. Welcome to the broadcast. We're in Genesis chapter 6, and we're learning faithfulness, obedience, and encouragement from the life of Noah. And we're talking about the sons of God, the angels of God. They looked down and saw the daughters of men, and that, you know what I'm saying, they left their heavenly abode to come and take wives with women. You know what I'm saying? Those women didn't have no, you know what I'm saying, a lot of extra, you know, makeup and jewelry and name brand clothes to try to attract a man. So a woman should never try to do that. Yes, keep yourself good, looking good and everything. Keep yourself smelling good, looking fresh. But don't do it to attract a man. Don't do it to make your other girlfriend or other women jealous. Let your motive be pure. You know what I'm saying? How to conduct yourself. How to present yourself. And you go to 1 Peter chapter 3, verses 1 through 8, and it will tell you how a woman of God should conduct herself. You know what I'm saying? In Titus chapter 2, it will tell you how the older women, how they're supposed to train the younger women. You know what I'm saying? So, you know what I'm saying? Anybody say you got to wear a dress all the way down to your ankles, you know what I'm saying, like that. But, you know what I'm saying, you ain't got to try to be trying to highlight your breasts. You ain't got to be trying to have your cleavage all out and to split all up here and coming into service and distracting men to try to, you know, seduce them after you. You ain't got to do that, because a true man of God, a man sent from above, that what the word said, James chapter 1. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Every good and perfect gift comes from the Father of light. You know what I'm saying? It comes from above, and there's no shadow of turning. When God sent them, they ain't going back. A Jezebel spirit. That's exactly what that is. A worldly, carnal spirit. You know what I'm saying? To try to attract the man through all this externalism. You know what I'm saying? While all the while they're hiding their true motives and intent and who they really are. You know what I'm saying? Man and woman, you know what I'm saying, created in the image of God. We are spirit beings. We live in physical bodies, and we have a living soul, mind, will, and emotions. You know what I'm saying? And God wants us to be whole. Nothing missing, nothing lacking. So when we just focusing on the outward appearance, you know what I'm saying? And we're not, you know what I'm saying, taking care of our inner man, who we really are. You know what I'm saying? We too busy, you know what I'm saying? Focusing on the outside of the house, but the inside of the house is jacked up. The dishes ain't done. The clothes ain't washed. The floor ain't been swept or mopped or vacuumed. Come on now. You know what I'm saying? The inside of the house is a mess. And that's what it is. Not just for women, men too. Don't get impressed with men externalism. You know what I'm saying? Just because they got a house and a car and their money and they own business. You know what I'm saying? Don't get impressed with that. God, the man looks on the outward appearance, but God looks on the heart. Look at his heart. You'll know the tree by the fruit it bear. Don't get impressed with leaves on the tree. Jesus went to the fig leaf tree, and you know what I'm saying? All he saw was leaves. He didn't see no fruit. You know what I'm saying? You got to be a fruit inspector, not a leaves inspector. Stop just looking on the outside. Look for the fruit. You don't see no fruit? Then you need to keep stepping. God ain't sent them. They ain't got nothing to give you. Nothing to supply your needs, nothing to satisfy you with, but they physical flesh, and that ain't nothing, because you know what? Leaves wither and they die, okay? Just like a man's, you know what I'm saying, stuff can do. He running out here sleeping with this woman, that woman, this woman, you know what I'm saying? Exactly, you know what I'm saying? Pretty soon he going to be dried up, you know what I'm saying, and wasted his substance, okay? Got no fruit. And yeah, he might have kids here, there, and everything like that, but then he don't have the, you know what I'm saying, the means to supply their needs, to take care of them, to protect them. Come on now. I ain't even gotten to this message, you know what I'm saying, to what this message is about. You know what I'm saying? We ain't even got past verse 2. Withered. You know it, sister. Let me move on. You know? And the Lord said, my spirit shall not always strive with man. Anyway, let's go down to, you know, so these angels, they left their heavenly abode, saw the women that were beautiful, and they took them to marry them. And out of that came giants. You know what I'm saying? So we know about, you know what I'm saying, the giants in the land. When David fought Goliath, he was from that clan. He was of the offspring of, you know what I'm saying, of those fallen angels, you know what I'm saying, who cohabitated with natural women, you know what I'm saying, and they produced giants. You know what I'm saying? And they were a terror unto people. You know what I'm saying? So there were giants on the earth in those days. Verse 4. And also afterward, when the sons of God, that means those fallen angels, came into the daughters of men, that means they had sexual relations with them. You know what I'm saying? And they bore children to them. Those were the mighty men who were of old, men of renown, giants. You know what I'm saying? So when you see a man 6 feet, something like that, not every man, you know what I'm saying, is sent from God. Don't get impressed that he, you know what I'm saying, tall, dark, and handsome, or blind with blue eyes, and he tall and whatever. Don't get impressed with the outside appearance. You don't know where he come from. He might be from his father, the devil, okay? Don't get impressed with that. His stature. God said don't look on his stature, because man looks on the outward appearance, but God looks at the heart. Look at the heart. Pray and ask God, who is this person? Why are they in my life? Did you send them? For what purpose are they in my life? Am I supposed to minister to them, plant a seed, water a seed in their life, help them on their way? You know what I'm saying? That don't mean that they my husband, my boyfriend, or they're supposed to court me. You got to seek the Lord. You want to be faithful and obedient to the Lord. Just don't run it after somebody because they give you some attention. You know what I'm saying? God give you attention 24/7, 365. Come on now. Come on now. So it said, then the Lord saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth. So we know that from Adam and Eve, you know what I'm saying, man and women, they were seduced and deceived to sin against God. You know what I'm saying? And we know that the first sin committed against another human was murder. Cain murdered Abel. You know what I'm saying? Broadcast is better. Thank you. Amen. God bless you, sister. But we see that it's one thing for, you know what I'm saying, that man be deceived into sin. But it's another, you know what I'm saying, that when these fallen angels came down and cohabitated with women, they produced these giants. And you know what I'm saying? And then things begin to get even worse. Verse 5 says, then the Lord saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every intent of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. This is talking about a fallen man and fallen angels, you know what I'm saying, and the results of that, okay? That, you know what I'm saying, the imagination of people's hearts, those who don't know God in the pardon of their sins, having been born of the Holy Spirit. That's why you need to check people and ask them, you know what I'm saying? Do you have a relationship with the Lord?
You know what I'm saying? Are you saved, you know, with the Holy Spirit? Because then we should see the fruit of the Spirit in your life. You know what I'm saying? If you want to court me, or you want to be interested in me, you want to be my friend, or you want to associate with me, you want to go into business with me, no. You know what I'm saying? You got to meet the heavenly requirement. Because if you don't, I can't be unequally yoked together with you. All I can do is minister you. Meaning, you know what I'm saying, sow the word of God in your life or water the seed that's already been sown. After I do that, I got to move on. Especially if you reject it. I can't stay there and try to teach you doctrine and stuff like that. You haven't even repented of your sins. I can't teach you the word of God because you can't comprehend what the Holy Spirit is saying. You got to be born of the Holy Spirit to receive and understand the things of the Spirit. So I can't teach you doctrine. So those of you that might be watching this broadcast, you're seeking the Lord, you got to repent of your sins and turn and put your faith in the finished work of Christ. And he said, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins. And you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost, for the promises unto you and to your children, to as many as our God shall call. So until you do that, you can't understand the things of the Spirit. You might have surface knowledge. Anybody can read and have a knowledge of, you know what I'm saying, your natural man have had understanding, but you don't have spiritual revelation. You don't have divine spiritual wisdom. You won't have that. You're not going to have the Holy Spirit to lead and guide you and empower you. You know what I'm saying? You're not going to be serving God. You can do a lot of good works, but you're not going to be doing the God work. You know what I'm saying? So don't deceive yourselves. You know what I'm saying? Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call on the Lord while he is near. Let the unrighteous man forsake his way. Huh? And let him return unto the Lord. Huh? Yes. Worship the Lord. That's right. God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. You got to be born again of the Holy Spirit to worship God in the Holy Spirit. Not with your natural dead spirit. You must be born again, born from above. Your natural spirit out of Adam is born from your mother's womb, is dead. All die in Adam. But in Christ, all shall be made alive. Amen. Praise God. That's the gospel right there. Until you get that right, you know what I'm saying? The gospel 101, you can't, you know what I'm saying? You're not going to be blessed by anything else. So that's going out for those who might be watching this broadcast here or watching the replay. If you're seeking the Lord, we're not condemning you. We're, you know what I'm saying? We're inviting you to come to the Lord. So he said, then the Lord saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every intent of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. Already, fallen man mixing with fallen angels, you know what I'm saying, like that. The fruit of that man's heart and his imagination and his intent is continually on evil. Born with a sinful nature. Slave to sin, the world, the flesh, and the devil. You know what I'm saying? Continually. And now you have TV. You know what I'm saying? Well, we can use all these tools, TV, internet, phone, whatever, for God's praise and glory, instead of sitting up in front of the TV and letting them project, you know what I'm saying, seduce us with seducing spirits, seducing images, you know what I'm saying, our imaginations and stuff like that. All it's doing is breeding covetousness in our heart, you know what I'm saying, which is idolatry. That we're sitting there, you know what I'm saying, seeing advertisements, get this new car, get this, you know what I'm saying, get this and get this, it's going to make your life better and everything like that. You think by filling your life with things is going to make your life better, and it develops in us a spirit of covetousness. You know what I'm saying? And people would do anything to get it. They'll rob, steal, kill, murder, anything to fulfill the lust of the eyes, the lust of the flesh, and the pride of life, which is not of the Father, it's of the world, and it's passing away. So, you know what I'm saying? So, we need to guard our hearts, guard our minds, guard our spirits, guard our bodies and souls, you know what I'm saying? And not just be sitting up there in front of the video games and these movies, horror movies, and all of this, you know what I'm saying? Watching people commit fornication, adultery, murder, rape, you know what I'm saying? All the works of the flesh. We need to, you know what I'm saying, be intentional. You know what I'm saying? And don't put that stuff, like the words say, like Solomon said in Ecclesiastes, make a covenant with your eyes. You know what I'm saying? I will not put no wicked thing before my eyes. That requires discipline. I did a scope, you know what I'm saying, cleaning, taking out the garbage. You know what I'm saying? I had all those movies, horror movies, sci-fi movies, comedies, dramas, all was worldly carnal movies. All it was breeding in me is, you know what I'm saying, my imagination on evil and lust and wanting to fulfill that. When you look at, we're looking at that stuff and everything and bring it into our mind and our soul and our spirit and our flesh, guess what? Our body's going to want to act it out. That's resurrecting that old man. And when we feed that old man, he going to get stronger. You know what I'm saying? The flesh is, spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. You know what I'm saying? And then temptation going to be great. That's why he said, you know what I'm saying, rise and pray lest you enter into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. We cannot, you know what I'm saying, thinking we strong, you know what I'm saying, that we can, you know what I'm saying, sit up there and soak up all this stuff. Empire, how to get away with murder, you know what I'm saying? Orange is a new black, you know what I'm saying? Walking Dead, Fear the Walking Dead, all this horror, fear. God is not giving us the fear of fear. When we sit there walking, at what you thinking? You're allowing them to minister to you a spirit of fear. You know what I'm saying? And then you like, oh, ah, what you think that? That's a response. That's a seed of fear, and you have response to fear. If it's not the fear holy reverence unto God, he said, cast it. Perfect love cast out fear. So we got to get rid of it. Don't give it no place. That's why we have to stay in the word. That's why we have to stay in prayer. That's why we have to guard our hearts and our minds. You know what I'm saying? Don't be deceived. The devil is real subtle. We sit up there, even when we're watching a wholesome, good program, commercial comes on, 30 seconds. You know what I'm saying? That time for the commercial come on, you know what I'm saying? Oh, this show coming out. Look, it's going to be hot and sexy. And oh, look, it's going to be action. They're killing, shoot them up, and all this kind of stuff. Ooh, coming to a theater new year. Coming out this fall, coming out this spring. A new show that's full with murder, fornication, adultery. You know what I'm saying? Horror. You know what I'm saying? Comedy. You know what I'm saying? Having fun and sinning. That's the message that's sending to us. So even then, on commercials, we need to mute it and turn the channel. You know what I'm saying? Turn it to something else. You know what I'm saying? To another better commercial. That's not trying to breed covetousness. Your imagination. The Bible said, gird up the loins of your mind. Tighten it up. Cast down. Take authority. Cast down every imagination and everything that attempts to exalt itself above the knowledge of God. Bring it into captivity. Cast it down. Don't give it no place. The Bible say, give no place to the devil. Submit your life to God. And then when the temptation comes and Satan comes, we have the power to resist the world, the flesh, the devil, temptation. We don't have to give in to it. We say, get thee behind me. I'm not even giving you place. I'm not even watching this. I'm not even giving you opportunity. And we're doing that, we're giving place to the devil, the world, the flesh, and the devil. You know what I'm saying? Sowing seeds into our imagination. All these images. Sitting up watching video games. Murder, death, kill. How to, you know what I'm saying? Steal and kill and rob and stuff like that. Getting desensitized to sin and the results of sin. The ways of sin is death. You know what I'm saying? So the devil is very subtle. He's not going to come to us, you know what I'm saying, in a red suit with pitchforks, looking like horrific. He hides. The words say that Satan comes as an angel of light. Likewise, his ministers transform themselves as ministers of righteousness, whose end shall be according to their works. They come in a lot of fashion and form. You know what I'm saying? Like that, these images to seduce us away from God. Thank you for inviting your followers. God bless you. You know what I'm saying? So we cannot be deceived. Don't be self-deceived thinking that because we are born again and stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? That we're not going to be tempted and that we can flirt with sin, play with the devil on one, you know what I'm saying, a little bit, and then we're going to run back to God and it's all good. No, you're not. You know what I'm saying? You're going to get yourself back into bondage. You know what I'm saying? The word says in Peter, 1 Peter chapter 2, I believe, you know, or 2 Peter chapter 2, you know what I'm saying? For whom a man is overcome, the same is brought into bondage. They are promising you liberty and freedom. You know what I'm saying? You got the freedom to do it, but all things are not, you know what I'm saying, beneficial for it. Then because you got the freedom to do it, you know what I'm saying, going to bring yourself into bondage. Yes, they need to hear this. Invite folks, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Do what you got to do. Tweet it, text it, keep sending it out. Give hearts. Thank you. God bless you. Tell them to watch the replay. See, people don't want to hear this. They want to go watch Empire. You know what I'm saying? And it's going to show them, you know what I'm saying, how to be conniving, how to be successful through deception. You know what I'm saying? How people backstab everybody and dig ditches for everybody. Set people up for power, for money. You know what I'm saying? That's all it's going to teach you is how to be worldly. That's all it's going to teach you. How to be worldly and be successful in sinning. But guess what? Be not deceived, because God said the wages of sin is death. Sin, when it has conceived, it bring forth, you know what I'm saying, death. When it is finished, it's bringing forth death. There is pleasure in sin. Don't get me wrong. That's what the word said in Hebrews. There is pleasure in sin. But guess what? It's only for a season. Just like the seasons change, we into fall, and then the fall going to be over, it's going to be winter. And then after that season is over, it's going to be spring. And after that season is over, it's going to be, you know, summer. Guess what? Seasons change. You know what I'm saying? And you're going to have to pay for that. Once it's time, once it's fully matured, it's going to bring forth death. You know what I'm saying? So don't be deceived. Don't think it's going to be like that all the way. You're going to have pleasure in sinning. You know what I'm saying? Because once that season of pleasure is over, you're going to have to pay for that. You're going to have to reap the fruit of that. And it might be, you know what I'm saying, people might catch AIDS, catching, you know what I'm saying, incurable disease by man. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? And there's people out there who got it, they don't care. They're going around sleeping with folks, knowing they got AIDS, giving people AIDS. You know what I'm saying? Don't be deceived. Don't think that, you know what I'm saying, because you're a child of God, you can go out there and commit fornication, even if you say you do, you know what I'm saying, use a condom or some protection. Right then, you're sinning against God. You say, God, I know, you know what I'm saying, this is wrong, but I'm going to be in protection out here to, you know what I'm saying, protect my body. But that's not going to protect your soul, your mind, your will, your emotions. You know what I'm saying? You're not going to have a peace of God. You're going to sacrifice that. You know what I'm saying? And you know what I'm saying? And it's still a potential, you know what I'm saying, that you still can catch a disease. You know what I'm saying? It's not 100% guaranteed. You know what I'm saying? And it's going to put you out of fellowship with God. The Holy Spirit is going to convict you and discipline you in your inner man and your spirit man. And nothing you can do to get away from that. You can run, but you can't hide from that. If you're a child of God, he's going to discipline you and tear you up from your spirit man, from the inside out. You're going to learn. The devil is a liar. That's right. When he comes to try to seduce you to partake of that fruit, you know what I'm saying? Don't get impressed with the outer appearance, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and pride of life. Refuse it. Anything the devil offers, anything the devil sells, we can do without. Refuse it. Tell him, get thee behind me, Satan. You know what I'm saying? Cast it down. Submit to God. Resist the devil. And when more and more we resist, you know, these things, and we're pleasing to God, our spirit man gets stronger. So when that temptation comes, we got victory over that. You know what I'm saying? We say, oh, no, devil, you got to come better than that. 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 I already see how you doing. I can see you coming a mile away. I'm going to keep you under my feet. I'm not even going to give you a chance. I'm going to put my foot on your head. That's right. Your body is a temple. But see, people think they can sin against the body, sin against the body, and then they're not going to pay the consequences of it. In their soul, their mind, their will, their emotions, they sacrifice the peace of God. In their spirit, man, the Holy Spirit will convict us to our core, discipline us. You know what I'm saying? Can't run from that. You know what I'm saying? You ain't gonna be able to function if you ain't got the peace of God. You know? So it's not worth it. So the devil trying to say, you know what I'm saying? He trying to, you know what I'm saying? Let me give you this and you get, you know, you serve and worship me. A trade-off. No, it's not worth it. It's not worth it. You already defeated. You know what I'm saying? You already defeated. No, you just trying to pull me down with you. Because when it's all said and done, I'm going to have to stand before my Lord and Savior and give an account. And I want him to say, well done, good and faithful servant. That's what we're here to learn, faithfulness and obedience and be encouragement from the life of Noah. Because look, that's how people are today. Nothing is new under the sun. Their minds and their tents, you know, are continually on evil. They sow it to their flesh every day. They don't walk after, you know, saying the things of the spirit. The Bible say, be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever man sow, that shall he reap. He that soweth to the flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption unto death. He that soweth to his spirit shall reap life everlasting. So don't be self-deceived. Don't let the devil deceive you. Don't let nobody else deceive you. I don't care what they say they is. Apostle, prophet, evangelist, pastor, teacher, man or woman of God. If they try to seduce you away from the will of God, you know what I'm saying? You need to flee from them. You know what I'm saying? He said they have a form of godliness, but they denying the power thereof. He said, from such, withdraw yourself. Run away from them. If you sit up under them, they trying to lead you astray, run. Run to God and say, God, you lead and you guide me to where you want me to be, unto faithful, obedient, you know what I'm saying, under shepherds. Run away from them. Because people's minds are continually on evil. Nothing is new under the sun. The same thing happened back there in Noah's day is the same thing that's going on today. People's minds that they don't know the Lord, they're not born again of the Holy Spirit, their minds are continually, you know what I'm saying, influenced on evil, continually. That's why you're seeing people sin without impunity. They commit crimes and have no remorse. You know what I'm saying? They ain't say, well, I feel sorry about that. Their consciences are seared as with a hot iron. You know what I'm saying? They ain't said, I'm sorry or whatever. If they do, they insincere. If they don't sow godly sorrow, which leads to repentance, you know? But we still got to pray for them. But you got to beware. Don't let down your guard on these folks. Don't, you know what I'm saying, on TV shows and stuff like that, movies. Don't be going and wasting God's inheritance in the kingdom of God that God bless us with and giving it to Hollywood. Those movies weren't made for us. The ones that are, support them. You know what I'm saying? Those artists that are doing Christian good work, that have a good message, that point people to Christ, the world, support them. You know, Christian artists, you know what I'm saying, contemporary, you know what I'm saying, traditional or Christian hip-hop, rap, gospel artists that are truly walking in being on faith and obedient to the Lord to win souls. Exactly. You know, can't serve two masters. You know what I'm saying? So we got to pray to the Lord. We just can't go, just because somebody say, Lord, Lord, we can't get impressed with that. We got to look at the fruit, listen to the message, look at their lifestyle. You know what I'm saying? Does it match up with what they're saying? You know what I'm saying? Can you see the fruit? You know what I'm saying? Because anybody can say, Lord, Lord, and anybody can fake it till they make it. We don't need to be trying to follow them and support them. We got to be a prayer for it. We got to think about it. Everything that God gives us, we're stewards over it. You know what I'm saying? That way we have to be good stewards over it, because we got to give an account for everything God gave us. Saying whether his spiritual gifts, you know saying, his mind, his wisdom, his peace, his fruit of the spirit, our material possessions, that's all part of the kingdom of God. Your house, your car, your apartment, everything God gives you, you are steward over. You have to give an account over. We have to give an account over. We just can't, you know what I'm saying, be, you know what I'm saying, giving it to the world. That's in the kingdom. Every red penny that God give us, we are stewards over it. We don't supposed to be going out giving it to the world. God don't look and say, you know what? They're unfaithful in that which is least. They're not ready to be faithful over much. I can't trust them with much. Why? Because I've given them a little bit, I supplied their needs, and I've given them more to be a blessing to somebody else, you know what I'm saying? And look what they're doing with it. They're going out to the movie theater, listening to, you know what I'm saying, giving it to Hollywood, watching these carnal, lustful, fleshly, prideful movies, you know what I'm saying? They're going out, buying this stuff, you know what I'm saying, video games and movies and all this stuff that don't, you know what I'm saying, sow to the spirit. They get it to their kids. They're going out there, you know what I'm saying, buying all this materialism to try to, you know what I'm saying, keep up with the Joneses. They're not paying their bills on time, you know what I'm saying? They're misrepresenting me. We're representatives of the Lord. So when we don't pay our bills, we don't pay them on time, then guess what? People, that's part of our witness. People going to say, okay, you say you're a child of God and everything like that, but based on your record, you a deadbeat. You don't pay your taxes. You know what I'm saying? I've been guilty. You know what I'm saying? You don't pay your child support. They read your report. They're speaking your life. You don't pay your bills on time. You know what I'm saying? You're in debt. You don't pay your student loan. You know what I'm saying? They're going to look at your record where they can see. You can say that all you want. They're going to look at what they can see in the natural. See? Let your light shine that men may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. We got to go to God and say, Lord, help me. You say, oh, no man, anything but love. So we got to be honest with God and say, Lord, I need help. You already blessed me, and I was not a good steward. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? I wasted it like the prodigal son. I didn't do what the right thing I needed to do. I didn't pay the bills like I was supposed to do. I didn't help the people that you told me to help when you told me you led me. So, Lord, I ask you to forgive me. I repent of that. Give me another chance, Lord. Send me increase. Don't just supply my needs, Lord. Bless me so I can be a blessing, Lord. Charge them that are rich in this world, that they be not high-minded nor trust in uncertain riches, but in the living God who gives us richly all things to enjoy. You know what I'm saying? That they be rich in good works, willing to distribute, willing to communicate, to help people when an opportunity presents itself. And we have therefore opportunity, let us do good unto all men, especially unto those of the household of faith. Lord, help us. Help me to pay my student loan. Help me to pay my taxes. Help me, Lord, to pay, you know what I'm saying, my child support. Help me, Lord, you know what I'm saying? Even, Lord, help me to forgive other people that owe me. Forgive us our debts, and, you know what I'm saying, as we forgive others. Come on now, y'all. We got to be honest with God. Everybody pops, trying to grind, and we ain't got time for God. We ain't got time to pray, time to study, you know what I'm saying, time to fellowship, time to help anybody, because we out there striving, all talking about we hustling and we grinding. That's under the curse, you know what I'm saying, under the sweat of your brow. You know what I'm saying? God can give it to you. He can bless you. You know what I'm saying? If you're faithful with that which is least, he'll make you rule over much. He will bless you with more so you can, you know what I'm saying, be a help to help other people, to sow it into the kingdom, to bring that his kingdom come to the path of Christ. God. Amen. Praise God. We got to stop this. So God decided that he was going to destroy earth with a flood. So, you know, so he was grieved that he made beast. Because the word says in Romans 8 that the nation groans and travails. They're waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God. We are the sons of God. We're not those sons of God that are from Israel. You know, they're in chains of darkness until the day of judgment. On that number. Okay, so don't be deceived. No. Like, I'm not pouring out. I'm not going to be more than one message. I'm about to stop this. If not, we're going to repass it to part 3. If you're not fitting in the evening, and stuff, I'm going to flag. I'll say one time, you know. When I feel, hey, like that, I go to the window. Hey, it's good. You always complain. Can you close your window? I just because it's and void carries more. So I haven't said my neighbors. So y'all give me feedback. People out there, one. I see y'all. You know, a lot of you. You've been faithful. Miss Priest, God bless you. Where you at? Sir, I appreciate you. Let's see. So this is a good one, type of one. If it's if you happen to keep going in and out, it's freezing up and jumpy, put a 2. Because my broadcast is not good. I'm not getting no feedback, y'all. We feed it to the Lord. Okay? So we got a lot to cover. And this being brought to you. Nobody there? Nobody there? Amen. Praise God. But we gotta be faithful. We're gonna live more, and then we're gonna use wisdom and stop the broadcast. I'm tempted to go ahead and stop it now. You know, it's not because nobody's there. Because on my end as well, it's jumpy. You know, it's jumpy like that. You know, and so just thank you back. Broadcast with prayer. We come back tomorrow. Do intercession. You know, for me, so you get a notification and come here. I'm taking your request, making actions for all God. You already made a quiet and peaceful life. All God, and His words, even your enemies, even up praying for them as well. Everybody, and I pray for use wisdom. Back tea, he poop. You know, I'm like that. You know, my body needs rest. Matter of fact, I'm thinking about going and soaking them. So, man, praise God. So, I'm gonna just word of a blessing to attendees, your protection, even those who have just been in attendance, and they say people are protecting the Christ soul. Holy Father, for hearing us, and thank you, Holy Spirit, for speaking to us and us for giving us the ear to hear what you're saying. Let only be hearers of your word, be doers of your word, and your strength, and wisdom, stand and strength, and power. You do worry, Father, praising glory to an extreme place, being an effective, powerful witness, and to millions and millions that you draw careful. And we all the praise of Jesus and pray. We from chapter verses 20. Now may you look for the edge of sheep. Through the blood of the everlasting, and work to do. Were you what is well pleasing in His sight, forever and ever. Amen. Praise God. God bless you. I love you. Please give me strength in the Lord, my spiritual strength, and my mind, my will, and emotion. Thank you. I love you. Have us in Jesus Christ.